Good evening and welcome to our Choral Evensong. My junior Choral Evensong. It's really great that you could all be here, and I'll start by thanking the choir, the funeral, and the children as well. They've done an amazing job, and I already thank them in the best year, and I'm thanking them again because they really enhance our worship in the church. It's really great that we are all here as the leaders in this Choral Evensong. When it comes to the hymns, we sing together, but everything as a canticle will be sung by the choir. And when it comes to the glory, I will just stand. So basically, today it's a worship feast. You are here to worship. Most of the time, I'm in silence and just reflecting. So thank you for coming, and let's continue our service as we sing our first hymn.
Thank you.
Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather hath given tongue from his wickedness and me, and hath given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce on his people being penitent the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his Holy Gospel. Wherefore, let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, that and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father.
Our Father,
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
first lesson is taken from the first book of Samuel, chapter 9, verses 1 to 14. There was a Benjaminite, a man of standing, whose name was Kish, son of Abiel, the son of Zeror, the son of Bechorath, the son of the fire of Benjamin. Kish had a son named Saul, as handsome a young man as could be found anywhere in Israel, and he was a head taller than anyone else. Now the donkeys belonging to Saul's father Kish were lost, and Kish said to his son Saul, "Take one of the servants with you and go and look for the donkeys." So he passed through the hill country of Ephraim and through the area around Shalisha, but they did not find them. They went on into the district of Shalem, but the donkeys were not there. Then he passed through the territory of Benjamin, but they did not find them. When they reached the district of Zuph, Saul said to the servant who was with him, "Come, let's go back, or my father will stop thinking about the donkeys and start worrying about us." But the servant replied, "Look, in this town there is a man of God. He is highly respected, and everything he says comes true. Let's go there now. Perhaps he will tell us what way to take." Saul said to his servant, "If we go, what can we give the man? The food in our sacks is gone. We have no gift to take a man of God. What do we have?" The servant answered him again, "Look," he said, "I have a quarter of a shekel of silver. I will give it to the man of God so that he will tell us what way to take." Formerly in Israel, if someone went to inquire of God, they would say, "Come, let us go to the seer," because the prophet of today used to be called a seer. "Good," Saul said to his servant, "come, let's go." So they set out for the town where the man of God was. As they were going up the hill to the town, they met some young women coming out to draw water, and they asked them, "Is the seer here?" "He is," they answered. "He is ahead of you. Hurry now. He has just come to our town today, for the people have a sacrifice at the high place. As soon as you enter the town, you will find him before he goes up to the high place to eat. The people will not begin eating until he comes, because he must bless the sacrifice. Afterwards, those who are invited will eat. Go up now. You shall find him about this time." They went up to the town, and as they were entering it, there was Samuel, coming towards them on his way up to the high place. Here endeth the first lesson.
Thank you.
second lesson is taken from the second letter to Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 6, verses 1 to 13. As God's fellow workers, we urge you not to receive God's grace in vain. For he says, in the time of my favour I heard you, and in the day of salvation I helped you. I tell you, now is the time of God's favour, now is the day of salvation. We put no stumbling block in anyone's path, so that our ministry will not be discredited.
Rather, as servants of God, we commend ourselves in every way, in great endurance, in troubles, hardships and distresses, in beatings, imprisonments and riots, in hard work, sleepless nights and hunger, in purity, understanding, patience and kindness, in the Holy Spirit and in sincere love, in the truthful speech and in the power of God, with weapons of righteousness in the right hand and in the left, through glory and dishonour, bad report and good report, genuine yet regarded as impostors, known yet regarded as unknown, dying and yet we live on, beaten and yet not killed, sorrowful yet always rejoicing, poor yet many making rich, having nothing and yet possessing everything.
We have spoken freely to you, Corinthians, and open wide our hearts to you. We are not withholding our affection from you, but are withholding yours from us. As a fair exchange, I speak as to my children. Open wide your hearts also. Here endeth the second lesson.
Thank you.
continue the service as we hear from our faith in the words of the apostles. I believe.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From this he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray.
us pray.
God of the ages, you are the beginning of our journey and our strength as we pause along the way. Hold us by the hand as we grow, show us where to seek you, and guide our steps that we may find you. Give us devoted hearts that we may love you, and your peace when we reach our journey's end. Amen. God, our Creator, you have given us talents and discipline, which help us to play and to compete together. Whether we win or fail, let us be gracious, and let us never be glad at another's setbacks. Grant that when we use the skills you have given us, we may recall you, the source of all our abilities. Amen.
We thank you, our Father, for the varied talents you have given to your children. To some, the gift of music or painting. To others, of writing or athletic skills. Above all, we thank you for the greater gifts of understanding, sympathy, and friendship, which can help and bring happiness to each other. Show each of us what your special gifts are to us, and enable us to use them for your glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord God, the eternal spring of all that is worthy and lovely in this world, we thank you for the gift of music. Let the mystery and power of its inspiration draw us closer into the fellowship with you and into deeper gratitude for all your blessing upon us, now and always, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Loving God, we pray for all children as they prepare for a new season in their lives. As they start nursery or school for the first time, give them joy in new experiences. As they move to new classes, give them confidence in growing friendships. As they move to new schools, give them strength in their growing independence. As they move on to college or university, give them wisdom in their maturity. And for all the teachers, assistants, helpers, carers and volunteers who teach and nurture us, we ask for your blessing now and always. Amen. Let us conclude our prayers this evening by saying together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God.
I speak in the name of Almighty God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, this evening is not going to be as sad as you know it, but one of me expressing my gratitude, my appreciation to the choir, of course, to the children. It's amazing because when we think of the givings, the Bible means we have most of God. Discussing with you and choosing now. This is nice. The first one is full of, you know, nice things. I'm talking about Saul looking for his father's donkey and Saul being described as a very handsome man, you know. All those things, it makes you chuckle. But then it comes to the second reading where Paul was talking about, you know, God's appointed time. But not just that, he starts by saying we should make sure that we don't have God's grace in our lives in vain. It is not in vain. Nothing is wasted. The prayers, you know, reminded us of the gifts we have all received from God, but also reminds us that actually those gifts are to be used. And Paul was encouraging the church in Corinth to be a church that appreciates one another, a church that has, one of the prayers says, honors friendship above that competitive nature, saying, oh, you are not as good as I am. No, it's embracing one and all, getting everyone to realize that they have something to offer. And of course, That same letter, I believe in the second reading, in that same letter, Paul talks about not being people who build barriers, but rather people who build bridges. He talks about stumbling block. And I have something here. The other one has gone somewhere now, but I thought it's really interesting sometimes to have an image in our head. It helps us to get things to sink in. You talk about broad bridges and things like that. If you are going to cross a bridge and the light, even like tintax, and the light starts flashing, the last thing you want to do is to race through because you know you might not just make it. So you stop and allow the light to flash at the barrier to come down. But actually, you don't want that barrier to be there forever, do you? It comes up again so that actually cars can travel. So sometimes we have the opportunity to be people who actually put those barriers down so it becomes bridges that people can go through. And that is what Paul is saying, that each one of us can and should be bridge builders. Don't allow anything, probably fear, probably lack of confidence, lack of self-esteem, whatever it is, don't allow those things to get you to the point where you put your guns off. You think, I'm just going to build a barrier around myself, a cocoon. Because we are none of us, each one of us, no one is meant to be an island. We are meant to, yes, sometimes, if you want to put it that way, yes, it might not sound nice, but we need to let our guns down and allow people to come close so we can actually build a bridge and not just build a bridge, actually build something even more beautiful that will allow traffic to flow, that will allow people to flourish. Because as Christians, we are called to grow, yes, but we are actually called to nurture one another in our growing. We don't just grow by ourselves or ourselves, we grow in the presence of others, and we grow by nurturing one another. So as we have been blessed, well, I've been blessed by the junior choir tonight, I hope we will continue to try to make it our duty, our joy, to be a blessing to one another, so that when we feel low, we'll have someone that can lift us up. And when we are really, really up there, we can look for someone that is in need of being lifted up. So we will be there for each other, we'll be there for one another. Because tonight, the service reminds us that actually, today indeed is the day of God's salvation. We cannot be stumbling blocks to anyone. It doesn't matter how young they are. And actually, it doesn't matter how old they are. So young and old, we all have something to offer. So thank you to the junior choir, to Fiona, and of course all the other members of the choir. And thank you to parents for encouraging the children. I know that times when they want to come, it's going to be fun. And of course they come and they say, it's actually, it was fun. And other times they might not be fun. They say, actually, it's really worth anything. Because sometimes life is like that. We don't always have things going the way we want them to go. We have to take it off on us. But thank you for being here, because we have been worshipping together, but we've been worshipping tonight, being led by children. And some churches will think, oh, children, they should be seen and not heard. But here, we're actually encouraged by their presence because they bless us. And of course, we bless them as well. But that mutuality is there. And that is what the Christian gospel calls for mutuality. Mutuality in terms of talents, but mutuality in terms of age, of course, in terms of gender as well as sexuality, all those things. So if you feel different, celebrate your difference, because it is a gift from God. And I pray that you'll be a bridge builder and that others will be there to help you construct something beautiful, not just for yourself, but for everyone else. So thank you for coming, and I pray that God will continue to bless each one of us, even as we continue on that journey of faith together, because it is an exciting journey. It's full of tragedy sometimes, but nonetheless it's exciting, because we've got God with us. And as the hymn says, with Christ in the vessel, what will happen? Who knows that hymn? With Christ in the vessel, what happens? Begone of the belief. No one knows that hymn. But it says, with Christ in the vessel, and smile like the storm. because the storm of life can come, but we have a God who is able and always willing to overcome those storms with us, for His praise and to His glory. Amen.
Hello. Before we have our last hymn, first of all, thanks for coming, this is great. The choir has been presented with an award to give termly to a child. A member of the congregation who can't be here this evening because he's having knee surgery, unfortunately, bad timing, but he wanted to present an award to a member of the junior choir in memory of his wife, who died a few years ago, but he was a member of this congregation and was a musician. And so what he wanted was, for once a term, for us to recognise a child who has done something particularly special during that term or during that time, or has just been a great servant to the choir over the last few years. But it's completely up to me what I like to do, so that's really good. But basically, for our first award, and it's very exciting, we put it on a very pretty greenish ribbon, teal, I think you might call it, some other reason. But the first award is going to a child who, when we went into lockdown in 2020, this child was really very young, had really only just started in the choir. And then we came back from lockdown 2 years later, and suddenly this child was among the most senior of the children that were left in the choir. And that was a big, big gap without having had any singing. And my expectation of this child and all of the children who came back was huge. I expected them to just get on with it, no fuss, we had lots and lots of new children at the time. And this one child has stood up throughout this last year and has just been absolutely amazing. And I'm going to tell you some of the amazing things that I think she has done this year. First of all, her attendance has been unbelievable throughout the year. She's always here every Sunday. And not only is she here every Sunday, she's here with a smile on her face. When I come into the vestry and she says, hello, like this, and she's always here before me. And because she's always here before me, she has already sorted out all of the music for the children who are coming. She's very, very organised. Earlier this year, a number of our children were off doing something else. They were doing a play, it was very good. But the children who were left here, there weren't very many of them. And so this child, who was still really quite young at the time, ended up being one of the most senior choristers who was here every week, leading these little children, these new children that didn't know what they were doing. And she did it absolutely brilliantly, to the point where a few weeks ago she was the most senior child here and ended up surplusing a child who was bigger than her. But that's just the way that it's been. She has been so brilliant with the new children throughout the year. She has never complained once about anything. She's always smiling and cheery. And so the very first Celia Stone Chorister Award is going to go to Marcy.
Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you evermore.